It's been about 10 months since COVID-19 vaccines first became available to the public. And now we're beginning to hear information about additional doses or boosters that may be necessary to fight off the virus. This raises questions of, was the initial vaccines protective enough, or will we need more boosters in the future? Well, I want to break down some of that information because it's coming in at real time and it can be quite confusing. But first, let's look at, do we need additional boosters for other vaccines? And the answer is yes. This can be due to a variety of different factors. When we're younger, we get a lot of vaccines. And as we get older, we need to remind our bodies what those pathogens looked like in order to protect ourselves in case we come in contact with them in the future. Additionally, this can be due to the location that someone goes to. If you're going on vacation or a business trip to a particular climate, there's different pathogens that live in those areas. And you may need to remind your bodies what those particular pathogens look like as you go there from time to time. But what makes the COVID-19 vaccine a bit different is that SARS-CoV-2 is found worldwide. Therefore, our bodies are constantly coming in contact with this virus, and we need to be able to protect it at all times. Now, you can think of antibodies in your body kind of like a leaky faucet. And slowly, over time, we begin to lose some of those antibodies, or the water begins to drip out of the faucet. Now, this isn't going to run our well dry. However, if we have a fire, we are going to want as much water as possible. And we can think of this fire like an infection. If SARS-CoV-2 is infected in our bodies, we're going to want as many antibodies as possible to neutralize that virus and protect us. And one way to boost the number of antibodies is through a booster shot. Now, in the US, there are three different categories of individuals who can receive a booster vaccine. The first is anyone who received a Johnson & Johnson vaccine more than 2 months ago who is 18 years or older. The second is anyone who received a Moderna or Pfizer vaccine more than 6 months ago that's 65 years or older. And the third is anyone who received a Moderna or Pfizer vaccine more than 6 months ago that's 18 years or older that has an underlying health condition or who works in an occupation that they may encounter the SARS-CoV-2 virus. However, this is three different categories with three different types of vaccines. Can you get a different vaccine from your initial regimen? The answer is yes. You can mix these vaccines. Now, two studies, one from the NIH and another from Sweden, both show the similar data that anyone who received a viral vector vaccine, such as that made by Johnson & Johnson or AstraZeneca, benefited the most by receiving a booster that is from an mRNA type or those from Pfizer or Moderna. Additionally, if you originally started out with Pfizer or Moderna, receiving another mRNA type vaccine was equally as protective as a booster. Now, luckily, since you can mix these vaccines, this streamlines the process and makes it quite easy. You don't need to search around different locations to find the exact manufacturer of your initial dose. You can just show up at any of the different locations and get whatever is most available to you. However, you can also make this decision yourself. If you originally received a Pfizer vaccine, you didn't have any side effects, maybe you want to receive Pfizer as your booster, and that is completely okay. Now, I'm going to post these links to a variety of different studies, as well as some charts depicting who can get a vaccine and mixing these vaccines in the links below, and I'll be sure to update them as more data becomes available.